So I'm afraid to talk about it on Twitter, so I'm going to talk about it here. I see on Twitter all the time people saying at Hank Green has rendezvous vibes. What is a rendezvous?
My cat is quite old. I hope he doesn't pass away.
Megalovania is a really good song on piano tubo.
Listen, I was thinking about this show way too much. Some of the quotes on the Dream SMP are too good to be in a Minecraft roleplay. I said it. Some of those quotes are too powerful to be from a Blockman roleplay. Because if I was on the server and I was doing my funny little haha Discord, haha, you know, like fighting Dream or whatever, and then suddenly someone drops, "If gods can bleed, gods can die," into the conversation, I think I just have to leave. I think I just have to respectfully log off. Because there's no way in hell I'm continuing the conversation from something that should belong in the fucking scriptures. I don't think I like fully understood the power of an English major and having several of them in one place until I started watching this shit.
Not sure I believe that shit.
What do you mean you don't believe it?
I'm not sure I believe it.
Oh my goodness.
I think you're sussy.
Please don't call me that.
Okay,
don't
meow.
Don't you dare. No!
Part 3 of Synesthesia Stuff. Ronbu's voice is pink, like my hair. And it has like black undertones, kind of. It sounds like I'm sitting on the roof looking up at the stars in the night sky. It tastes like Siam rolls from this very specific Thai place that I go to. It feels like wearing a hat. Tubbo's voice is like purple and yellow, not mixed, but like swirled. It sounds like one of those tiny pianos, but it's also like topaz. It tastes like the end of one of those orange creamsicles. Techno's voice is like gray, blue, green, and pink. It reminds me of chewing on metal of necklaces, but it also sounds like covering your fingers in paint and finger painting. Tommy's voice is like a light yellow and cerulean. It sounds like a school playground at recess on a Friday. It's like waking up and finding out that it's going to be a snow day. It also sounds like that raindrop noise that you can make with your mouth. I think it's like that thing.
Yeah. Say cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger?
Say trash.
So, on yesterday's episode, we talked about George Not Found fans and Quackity fans, but today I would like to bring up the anomaly of Jack Manifold fans. They simply cannot be described. They don't usually make edits of him that are... you know, hot? No. What they do is this. And, well, that's fine and dandy. It's not just one video, it's all of them.
Jack Manifold? Jack Manifold? Jack Manifold!
Do we need to go and check up on Jack Manifold's fans? Like, are they okay?
I have a better plan. I'll marry a wealthy man.
Wouldn't that make you gay?
Not necessarily.
That would be okay. What?
I'll sleep in a separate bed, and I'll refrain from giving kisses. We'll be happy for a while. I'll try to comply to his style and keep his mansion clean. Then I'll kill him and inherit his...
Days pull you down just like a sinking ship. Floating is getting harder, but tread the water, child.
Random facts about Bad Boy Halo, specifically because I did a video about different creators,
But now it's just Bad Boy Halo, because this man is so interesting. He is licensed to carry, owns firearms, and used to shoot recreationally. He threw knives competitively, and won some competitions because of it. He cuts his nails with kitchen scissors, or has in the past. He caused a power outage for his entire town because he ran into an electricity pole thing. I'm pretty sure in high school he started lifting weights to beat up his bullies. Don't quote me on that though. He's an ordained minister. He's ambidextrous but hates left-handed people, or using his left hand, I'm not sure which one. In 2019, his assumed age was 29. He had a gambling addiction. I don't know what happened with that. And he does all of this without swearing. What the fuck? I'm scared of him.
You a big music enjoyer?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of music? Hit me with a song right now.
The same song on repeat for like an hour.
You're a funny one, you know you are.
I really am.
That's why you're my favorite.
I'm your favorite.
You're my favorite. I've decided
you're
it.
You're my favorite.
I'm your favorite.
Just ever. Mm-hmm.
I hate. Wait. I'm done hating. Today is love. I love today.
So, you know how you, like, project a little bit of yourself onto the characters that you write? Yeah, well, I was just thinking about that because, the universal trait of all of Dream's characters is that he simps for George, including in Tales from the SMP.
I'm tired.
Come on.
Leave me alone.
Never. Oh yeah, no, when you're tired, I'm gonna have energy, and then it's gonna be really, really funny. Because I'm just not gonna leave you alone.
I'm gonna put you to sleep.
How would you do that?
Heavy object.
Oh. Oh.
Someone in chat asked if you are gay. I'm not gay. Sorry. Sorry. You shouldn't have to... I don't feel like... Should I have to apologize for that? Sorry to men. I apologize, men. You're missing out. There you go. That's what I mean by sorry when I say that.
Something to drink or anything?
I could use some appy slices, actually, if you wouldn't mind.
And a little peanut butter to dip them in?
Fucking of course I want peanut butter, Clint!
Okay,
honey. Here we go.
I think some of y'all are forgetting that Dream has written self-insert Percy Jackson fanfiction, which also means he's probably read self-insert Percy Jackson fanfiction, which means he probably has either an AO3 account or a Wattpad account, which means he could be reading anything. He also could be writing anything because, as we know, he likes to write. So, God, that's terrifying.
I never understood why you made this path so wiggly.
It was a wiggly time in my life.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. No man should be forced to wiggle against his will.
I was wiggling so far against my will, but you don't even understand.
I'm so sorry. You should really see someone.
I did, and then they beat me to death, so...
Oh my God.
I just really miss my wife.
That's nice and all, but I really need you to write in that lore now.
Wife. Lore.
Wife lore!
There we go. Do it.
You know I got executed. Yeah, I know. Have I ever told you this? I got executed.
You did?
Yeah, technically. Do me up.
What? Why did he blow you up?
He was peer pressured into it by Schlatt and Big U.
By Quackity again?
Yeah, see, I'm starting to establish a pattern of behavior, if you know what I mean. I can tell you, because chances are you won't remember any of this, but I'm just speaking my thoughts aloud. Like, I'm starting to notice a pattern of behavior.
Yeah, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
From that?
Yeah, you know, a little bit burnt from firework explosions, but it's fine.
Yeah, I know. I never wanted to bring that up, but yeah.